Good day to you folks, Larry G. McGuire here at Chimp Tutorials. It's where you go to learn MailChimp, new resource. As part of the resource, I'm building out some tutorial material. In this particular tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a simple marketing funnel using MailChimp and a couple other tools. Quite straightforward. If you've got a presence online, you look to generate leads and sales through your website, well then implementing a little process like the one I'm going to show you will help you add people to your list, and most importantly know where they came from so you can send them the right message at the right time. Before we jump into the material, just want to say a quick thanks to Entonon members, Entrepreneurs Anonymous, for clicking on the link in the WhatsApp group, for visiting the page, for signing up and helping me put this together. You can catch this video on LinkedIn if you're watching on LinkedIn, howdy. If you're watching on YouTube, howdy. You're watching on WhatsApp, howdy too. So without further ado, let's get into the material. I'll show you what's the story. Okay, so in this tutorial, how to create a simple marketing funnel using MailChimp, you're going to need three things. First thing, obviously, a MailChimp account. It doesn't need to be a paid account. It can be a free account. Second thing you're going to need is a website, preferably WordPress, although you can make this work on pretty much any website platform, but I prefer WordPress. Over 30% of the internet is built, websites are built with WordPress, so it's a good solution. And then thirdly, you'll need a Sumo account. If you don't, if you're not familiar with Sumo, you can check it out at sumo.com. It's a free tool, and there's a paid account as well, but the free version will allow you to do what I'm going to show you, which is essentially capture emails on your site by offering something valuable or interesting, or something that helps a reader or visitor to your site get where they want to go. So those three things are required. Let's jump into the material. Reduce that down. So the first thing you want to create is a couple of pages, two pages on your site. The first one is your landing page. This is where you're going to drop in your contact form, or rather your sign up form. And to do that, if you're familiar with WordPress, just go to pages, new page, and create a page. With most themes in WordPress, you can create a landing page. It's just hyper-focused on the content rather than including menus and all that kind of stuff. It cuts all those things out and just focuses attention on the content. So if you've got those options, choose landing rather than the default page template. Next, you want to drop in your content. Pick a headline that communicates the message. In this case, it's Welcome Entrepreneurs Anonymous Members. They're the people that I was in contact earlier about this little process, and add some content, page content. And once you've added the written content and any images you want to add, the next thing we want to do is add a space for the form. It's a HTML form, and I'll show you where we're going to grab that code shortly. But before we leave, we're going to add a HTML element. This is the new block setup inside WordPress, by the way. It's the latest version, Gutenberg version of WordPress. So if it looks unfamiliar, that's why. So add your HTML block, save that or update it, leave the window open, and what we're going to do is create our second page. The second page we're going to create is a thank you page, and the thank you page is where you send subscribers after they sign up. You can add a link to a freebie, you can add a link to a survey page in Google Forms or something like that, or some other incentive, additional incentive you want to give people. You can tell your subscribers what's going to happen next, what stuff they can expect to receive from you. If you've got an email series lined up, well, you can tell them about that. Keep it brief, and it just helps reinforce your message. So once you've got those two pages created, the next thing we're going to do is going to get over to MailChimp. This here is a demo account that I use for kind of messing about and testing stuff. What I want to show you here is how to create a group in MailChimp if you haven't got groups set up. So this is the newsletter. You go into your list, manage contacts, go to groups, and there's no group set up in here. So you your view might be the same as this. If you have groups already, just make sure they're aligned with the various, let's say, products that you offer or aspects of your business that you want to categorize your subscribers in or under. So click Create Groups. You don't want people to select these. These want to be hidden. Group category, so we just call this Chimp Tutorials. And then you can add names. In this case, Antonon is a group, and save that. Done for now. View groups, so you can see your groups. We want to create a merge tag. So click on settings and go to merge tags and add a field. Click text. And you want to name this Sumo because we're using the Sumo tool. You can name this what you like really, but this is just for demo purposes. We don't want it visible. And you can leave this as merge tree if you want, but I change it. And I'll show you why this is important now in a minute. And we leave the default merge tag empty and save changes. So I'm going to jump into my own active account now. So at the moment you can see there's nobody in the Antonon group, and that's going to change now shortly. When I finish the demo, I'm going to come back in here and show you. So next on the list, we want to jump into Sumo. If you haven't got Sumo yet, get over to sumo.com, sign up, it's free. Then drop the code into your site or get your developer to do it. Or if you're on WordPress, install the Sumo plugin and you'll be away in a hack. You want to create a form in Sumo. So click on Forms on the top menu, Create Form. And when you're forced to open up Sumo Forms, this is what you're presented with. I'll click through into that. So I've customized this. You can add fields by clicking Add New. You can duplicate fields by clicking on them and then click Duplicate at the top here. So that's what I did. I basically created two fields, first name and email field. And I've also edited the button to the color that I want and font size that I want, etc. Your consent checkbox here as well. And there's some customization here on the left-hand side for all of these elements. So once you're happy with your design, you've got your two fields. These, for me, these are a minimum, your first name and your email. You might choose not to ask for a first name, in which case you'll just delete that. This next little bit is the important bit. This is where the magic happens. If you see up here, there's a label, Hidden Fields. If you don't see that, click Add New. Hidden field, and what comes up is this. You remember earlier when we created the merge tag, we called it Sumo. Well, this is the basically the section within the Sumo app where we do the same thing. So it allows them both to speak to each other. It allows Sumo send the information and for MailChimp to receive it. So in this case, the variable name is Sumo, like we did in MailChimp. And the variable value we choose from these options here. And you might remember the value we left blank in MailChimp. Well, here we're going to choose the variable pop-up name. So the pop-up name is going to populate that field within MailChimp. And once you do that, any subscriber who subscribes to your email list using this form will be identifiable in your list as having come from here. So that's the little bit of magic in the background. Once you have that set up, all your forms will deliver that information to your MailChimp list. So once you you're happy with your design, click on Next. This is the code that you're going to need to drop into that HTML box you created on your page earlier. So we're just going to grab that now. Go back to the page, your landing page, and paste in your HTML. Click Save or Update. Go back to Sumo, and next on the list, click Next. This one's important too. This is why you need your thank you page, this redirect URL. This is where you want to send people after they sign up. That's this one we're creating here. This is the link to the thank you page that I used in the process. If you followed the process through to the end, you would have arrived on this page. So you want to paste that in there and click next. That's all you need to do for this simple setup. You can do other things in here like add an email, deliver a content upgrade or a bonus or a subscribe incentive or something like that. There's a whole pile of features in here, but this is all I want to look at just for the moment, is adding in your redirect URL when someone signs up. So once you've done that, click next. You want to connect to your email service. In this case, it's MailChimp. You can see there's a whole host of stuff in here. They've basically covered all the bases when it comes to email service integration. I've got double opt-in switched off. That's just my preference. So when you when you're in here, click on your MailChimp account and then choose your list, Larry McGuire list, and then you can see Chimp Tutorials. I want to add people to that Entenon group, if you remember a couple of minutes ago, that we created. So select that on. I've double opt-in disabled, like I said, click save, but click update, and that's your form. So when you go back into your WordPress page and you view that page, let's just update it here first. So you view that page. You can now see the form shows up static where you've pasted it on your page. So once I sign in, or subscribe, should I say, and click the consent box, you can see what happens now. I'll be taken through to the thank you page. My details go through to MailChimp, and I'll show you what that looks like inside MailChimp. Click on the button. You're redirected to the thank you page. And this is the thank you page that I've created. And like I said, I've got an extra little action that I'd like people to take. And that is to give me some feedback on what they need most, or what you need most with regard to MailChimp. So when people click on that, they go through to a form. So you have to sign in. But essentially, that form is basically what are you struggling with? What do you need help with most? And that helps me then create and refine my offering, if you know what I mean. So let's jump back to the groups in my MailChimp list under Chimp Tutorials. You can see Entenon. The Entenon group has one contact. That's me. Obviously removed everyone else for privacy sake. So you click on that and there's me. Under the Sumo merge tag is the Entenon form. If you remember, there are those changes. So the name of the form, Entenon form, that's now viewable in MailChimp. So I know that this person here came via that form. The source was Sumo. And that's it. Happy days. So that's all I've got for you. I hope that tutorial was helpful. If you need any further information, or if you have any questions or whatever, you can drop me a line in the WhatsApp group or on LinkedIn. You can email me at larry@chimptutorials.com. And don't forget to check out the article that accompanies this video later over on chimptutorials.com. Or if you want more stuff like this, sign up. And that's all I've got for you. Thanks very much, folks, for watching. And I'll see you later. Take it easy.